Hello and welcome to In the Paint with Cameron and Jordan. I am Cameron Sadeghi and this dude is Jordan Hunter.
Hello!
NBA games. We're talking about the big games, the key games coming up on the schedule. We led you up all the way to the All-Star break. But you know what? We said, you know what? Let's just finish this off. And what about Heat, Thunder at Chesapeake?
At home gives the Thunder an advantage. I don't know how big of an advantage since the Heat did beat them last season in Oklahoma City. It was a rout. But I think the Heat will win this one, obviously. They have more talent. I think LeBron matches up well with Durant still. Westbrook matches up well with Wade. But I don't think after that for OKC, they have much depth. So I'm going to go with the Heat. Straight out, easy win.
Yeah, I think it's going to be an easy win just for the simple fact that Miami has the better talent, like you said. And I just don't, even if the game comes close, the Thunder offense isn't good enough, just like the Heat offense is great because they really challenge the defense. It's kind of easy to just key on Westbrook and Durant when they're forcing tough shots.
Ibaka will be forced too.
And Ibaka to me is
the key. I think he honestly, though,
I don't see him as an offensive player, though.
I see him as an offensive player.
No. All he has, in my opinion,
is the mid-range.
He catches the ball, faces up, does that one jab to his right, another jab, and then the pull-up. That's it. If you crowd him up and you cut off the baseline, he can't drive with his left.
I still think, though, if he can develop a post move. But then again, it's all whether the Heat stick with their lineup or whether they do move.
Should Odin play on Ibaka and then Bosch play on Perkins?
Because then the big body on the best offensive player, which is Ibaka. So at times OKC is gonna try to go fast and put Durant at the four and see if Bosch can guard him, and I don't know if he can. Bosch gets puts on stilts a lot.
I know you hate this defense, but I'm going to just say it anyways. You know what? The Heat should just play a little bit of zone.
No.
Yes. Yes.
NBA's a man's game.
Oh, my God.
Man, zone is not
no.
a man's defense.
Well, then why did the Mavericks beat the Heat in the 2011
NBA
Finals?
The Mavericks were not men. The Mavericks were mere.
What are you talking about?
The Mavericks
They're high IQ players. The Miami Heat should know how to play against
the
2-3 zone.
The Mavs, I honestly think, that was the most forgetful NBA championship series ever. No one remembers that series. No one.
No, a lot of people do.
I was asleep too,
but a lot of other people remember that.
No, I don't think
Charles Barkley was screaming his head off.
Charles Barkley, he doesn't know what team Willie Green was on last
year. He's won two Emmys.
Oh my
gosh. Alright, let's move on. Clippers, Thunder, Chesapeake, Arena in Oklahoma City, ABC Sunday.
ABC Sunday. That is where OKC loves Sundays, you can see.
Yeah.
Especially on ABC. So what I'm going to say, I'm saying this right now. In my opinion, this will be sort of the passing of the torch from a young team in Thunder to the premier team, the Clippers. Clippers are a better team, better starting five. I don't know how they're going to contain the two shooters.
I just personally think that Doc Rivers has a better offensive system because he can run Redick off those pin downs and those double screens. And then Dudley really can shoot. I mean,
Dudley and Redick.
He can't play defense a lick, but Doc Rivers will make sure he plays defense. Redick plays some good D. Redick does a good job defensively. But Jared Dudley in Phoenix, my God. I've never even seen Jared Dudley in a defensive stance ever in my life.
Doc Rivers, he's kind of used to guys who can play defense. Look in Boston, he had great defense in Boston. Now he's going to have to see if he can play guys like Redick, Dudley, not good defenders. We'll see what he has to do with that. But back to the offense. They're going to have to be worried about Chris Paul and Blake Griffin going off. While over here you have J.J. Redick and Dudley spotting up for three. I don't know if they can contain them.
And then again,
the game is at home. So.
And you know what we would see in Boston when they would just do those little just one man screen on Allen, and then two defenders would go to Allen. To me, that's the same thing that's going to happen in the Clippers. Two defenders are going to go to Westbrook, and then you're going to have DeAndre and Blake getting wide open, easy finishes at the rim. So that's why I think the Clippers.
So what's your pick?
Clips by 15.
I say Clips, but by a margin of 5-7.
No.
After fouls and free throws.
Okay, fine.
15.
The Clippers.
That's an insult to the Thunder.
I thought you hated the Thunder.
No, they're not that bad. Okay. Okay. First of all, the Heat are a big step up from the Clippers.
Yeah. No, I actually think it could be Heat Clippers in the NBA. Maybe.
Ah, humbug. Oh my gosh. Oh, are you serious?
Okay, just, you know what? Before we even move on, what's your finals prediction? Let's just make it now, okay?
Finals prediction. Brooklyn and...
Okay, the only two teams in the East that I think have the best chance of making the NBA Finals are the Heat and the Pacers.
Why?
Pacers are better than the Nets right now.
Why are the Nets getting taken out of conversation? Why are they getting taken out of...
No, they are, but they're not better than the Heat or the Pacers
than the Pacers.
You really think so? We'll see in the playoffs. Let's move on.
The way it's going to be shaped out, they're going to see each other in the semis.
Well, guess what? We were just talking about the Heat and... Maybe the Bulls, we did yesterday, March 9th at the United Center, where the Heat, the 27-game win streak, went down. So, do the Bulls do the same thing and pull off the shocking upset at home?
Do the Bulls pull off the upset at home? Yes. The Bulls, numerous teams have had the Heat's number. The Celtics used to have it. The Knicks had it a season or two ago. The Bulls had it when Derrick Rose. That's why I don't think the Heat will win the championship. When so many teams have your number, as a championship team, you cannot let two or three teams have your number.
You have a little bit of a bias. You know why? I don't think you want the Heat to be in the same category as the Lakers with the three-peat.
It's not even the same question.
No.
That three-peat was a dynasty.
Okay, come on. In 2000, 2001... and 2002. The Heat have a chance to do the same thing the Lakers did.
That's a three-peat, but it's not as special as the Lakers.
Oh, my God. No. You know what?
Mark Madsen.
I wish we had video right now of him dancing around. He was trying to do his best Mark Madsen impersonation. But, okay, no. You know why this is more special than the Lakers?
What?
Because these guys are winning championships without a true dominant big man. You can't deny that. Did Chris Bosh play the five in Toronto? No. That's an unnatural position for him.
But one thing is, the Lakers didn't have the beast that LeBron James is. We never had a beast.
Oh, but you had Kobe, Bean, Bryant.
Okay, but then again, outside of Shaq, we had Kobe. But we didn't have, you could say Kobe was playing the LeBron, but we didn't have a Wade. Wade and LeBron complement each other so well.
You just don't want LeBron to get more rings.
No,
okay,
I don't.
My God, you just said that on radio.
I do not want LeBron to get another ring. I'm devastated when he got the second one.
Oh my God.
I was devastated.
Okay, the first one you didn't like? No, you didn't feel bad for him.
First one, I didn't care for.
Why? Just, you should have felt good for him because of all that criticism.
Just because I didn't feel that bad because I feel he deserved it.
Yeah, exactly.
They whooped the Thunder. Thunder.
Yeah, exactly.
So, the Spurs, questionable call, set the whole series.
Oh, my God. Who was more disciplined down the stretch?
I wouldn't say this one. I say it was a coaching error by Popovich.
Oh, no.
Just like in game one. Game one.
What
game coaching,
one? They won.
No, game one of the Pacers series in Eastern Conference Finals. Coaching error.
Okay, they could have still kicked it out to Bosh for three.
No.
Bosh just hit big time
shots.
I'm
saying, though, if Hibbert would have been in there, Bosh wouldn't have been open.
Yeah, no.
LeBron wouldn't have made the shot. Those
are all hypotheticals. First of all, the Pacers had many opportunities in other games. So just because you lost one game doesn't mean you can't win four games.
What I'm saying is, though, whether LeBron makes a shot or misses a shot, Eric Spoelstra is going into the video room with the same mentality. If he would have missed it, what would you have changed that you would not have changed if he would have made it? What would you have changed? Wouldn't have been much to change.
We gotta move on, though.
Let's move on.
We just talked Pacers.
Heat and Bulls. Heat and Bulls. What was your prediction?
Okay, real quick. I actually think the Bulls will win solely at home, but they gotta make it low scoring. I'm gonna shock you with this. 75-70.
I'm saying Bulls winning this 190.
What? Oh my god. You think the
Bulls. No defense by the Heat.
No. You think the Heat are gonna be able to score 90 on that defense?
Yeah, they can.
No.
They can.
No. Mario Chalmers is going to turn it over a lot because Derrick Rose is a really solid defender.
I'm saying Derrick Rose and Joakim Noah go off.
I say that it's going to be a low-scoring dogfight.
70-75?
Yeah. 75-70 Bulls.
I'm going, okay, I'll be generous. 90-80 Bulls.
Oh, come on. Okay, fine. I'll live with that. Spurs Rockets at the Toyota Center.
Did we say Pacers Heat? No.
Oh my god, it's Pacers Heat. ECF.
Pacers! Pacers!
At American Airlines.
The Indiana Pacers will pull it out. They're the better team. They're the better team.
Okay, first of all, this is April 11th, so they may come off of a back-to-back, and we...
Who cares?
Who cares? Everybody gets tired in the regular season.
Oh, back-to-back, my
Even
butt.
Even Beno Udrih gets tired in the regular season.
We'll talk about him later.
Okay, fine.
Pacers. What's your pick?
I'm going to go... Fine, I'll give it to the Pacers.
You cannot say that the Pacers can...
I'll go 90,
Pacers can win
I'll go 98-95. Is that fair?
Yeah. Okay. Pacers can win in Miami. They proved it.
Spurs Rockets.
Battle of the best team in Texas.
Southwest Division. Big time.
You know what I'm saying, though? This game could decide the Southwest Division.
Yeah,
I think
it really can.
Division... I normally don't say this often, but...
But the Spurs may rest their guys here, so I'm going to go with Houston.
I'd go with Houston anyway.
And you know what? I don't know if they... The only way they can contain Howard, and you're going to laugh at this every time I say it, is 2-3 zone. You know why they created 2-3 zone? Because of Shaquille O'Neal.
I don't think you go 2-3... Yeah, go to the game, sir. Sure.
Okay.
But what I'm saying, I normally don't say this. I think they're good. The Pelicans, Spurs, Rockets, three teams coming out of the Southwest. When was the last time that happened? Other than the three Texas teams coming out.
There's just so many teams good in the Southwest, in my opinion.
Dallas isn't bad. Dallas all right, is not bad.
We're going to play this funny game. I don't know. Some of you have seen Inside the NBA. It's called Who He Play For. But we're going to do a segment here called Which D-League Team Is It? So, I'm going to give a city name. By the way, Jordan's going to close his eyes. I'm going to ask him the city name, and he's going to tell me the team, and we'll see how many he gets right. So, this is just a little fun game. Jordan, don't look at the screen. When I say Austin, you say?
Toros. Austin Toros.
Bakersfield.
Jam.
Canton.
Don't tell me.
Don't look.
I know this. Canton. No, it's like, not Sage. Canton's not Storm.
5 seconds.
Canton Orange? Canton.
No. Two for three.
Rebels.
No. Don't look. Delaware.
Is that even a team?
Okay, wait. Canton is, by the way, the Charge.
I knew it was something like
Charge. Okay, Delaware. You're going to be shocked by this and don't even look.
Liberty?
87ers. 87.
What?
The Delaware 87. Okay, Erie.
Oh,
so you're
Erie Bayhawks.
Okay, so you're 3, 4, 5. Fort Wayne.
Mad Ants. Terrible name.
4 for 6. Idaho.
Stampede.
Oh my god, 5 for 7. Iowa.
Oh, gosh.
Don't look. You're gonna, when you hear this, you're going to get mad at yourself. I'm going to give you 5 seconds.
What is it?
Five.
What is it?
Energy.
Oh
my god, you're 5 for 8. You're 5 for 8. I know you know this one because you live pretty close to this area. Los Angeles.
defenders.
Good. Maine.
Red Lobster. Rome. No, Maine. No.
Red Claws. It's a Red Claws.
I was there.
No, you weren't. You missed it. You missed it. So you got...
You didn't give me enough time.
Six for nine. Reno.
Bighorns.
Man. Seven. Are you 7 for 10? Okay. 7 for 10. Rio Grande.
Vipers.
Okay. Santa Cruz.
Warriors.
Seo Falls.
What? Oh my gosh, what are these dumb names?
You would be shocked by this. It's the Sky Force, and it's the Heat's D-League team. I didn't even know that.
Wow, why?
Springfield, you're going to be shocked by this one.
Armor?
I'm shocked. What? You got that right?
Whoa! Whoa!
Okay, I'm going to just tell you the coach. Okay. Nancy Lieberman is a part of the coaching staff. Which team is this for? Or if you don't know, I'll tell you the state.
I don't know.
Texas.
Austin?
No, I'll give you one more try at the team name. Texas.
Rio Grande.
What is it? I'll give you 5, 4, 3, 2.
I don't know.
Texas Legends.
That's a team?
Yeah, the Mavericks. That's a D-League team. Oh. Remember when Allen Iverson was offered to play there, but he rejected it?
He should have accepted.
Tulsa.
I know Tulsa. I know it. 66ers.
You're right, so... He is really not that bad as knowing his D-League teams. He got 1, 2. He didn't get the Canton Charge or the Delaware 87ers, and I didn't even know the Delaware... I've never even seen the Delaware 87ers on NBA TV.
They never show them.
Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So you got 12
out of 17
teams in the NBA D League. Correct. Very special. Okay. Let's move on to something really funny. And Tom, no. You know what? You bring up the story about Cam. This is funny.
Okay, so I have a friend of mine. He was participating in... So Jason Thompson, who was the power forward for the Sacramento Kings, participating in his camp in Rancho Cordova, which is about 30-45 minutes away from Sacramento. And he said, he told me the story, how there was a freshman going into high school at our Sacramento high school, so that's Sac High. He challenged Jason Thompson to one-on-one, and he beat Jason Thompson. Jason Thompson wasn't going easy on him because Jason Thompson dunked on him 4 times. And when you can lose to a freshman in high school, I don't care if it's LeBron James, I don't care who it is, a freshman in high school.
Okay, but think about it. Jason Thompson probably wasn't playing hard.
He dunked on the kid 4 times.
Okay, but he didn't play any defense then. He doesn't want to get injured.
They don't need him.
They what did he say? Say it louder. I want to hear that.
They don't need him anyway. The Sacramento Kings suck.
Okay.
No.
Look, Jason Thompson's a really hard worker. You gotta admit that.
He's a hard worker. He's developed his jump shot more. But, you know, I still don't. I don't think he'll ever be an all-star, obviously. Or a star, good player. He's average.
But it's nice to go watch him at Sleep Train Arena.
No, it's not.
Well, I'm gonna go snooze again. At least before I go snooze, see a few Jason Thompson jump shots.
If you want to go have a good time, go to Oracle. If you want to sleep, go to Sleep Train.
Okay, you know what? I think you had a rant. Do you have any rants today before we end this?
I'm ranted out, man. You have... Oh, let's... First, we'd like
to... Should we talk about Sleep Train or Mark Madsen?
No, I think we should... Do you want to end off with... Some NBA news?
Okay, really quick. In the NBA, there here are some of the key headlines. We've seen Beno Udrih's on the Knicks.
I don't really
give a care. Because you hate the Knicks too?
No.
Can we just find out all the teams you hate?
I don't hate the Knicks. I do not. I enjoy watching them play. I think Carmelo Anthony is the best scorer in the league.
Okay.
Now, I don't think he can come off the bench. Yes, I think he's better than Pablo Prigioni because he can score. Pablo Prigioni was not a scorer whatsoever.
So would you take Pablo Prigioni in a one-on-one versus Beno?
I'd take Beno every day.
Beno every day? Wouldn't be even close?
It'd be close, but I don't think...
What about Mark Mattson, Slava Medvedenko versus Beno Udrih?
Both of them?
Yeah, both. Two on one.
Well...
And they can't shoot inside the paint. They have to shoot outside the paint.
I'd have to go with Medvedenko and Mattson. I'd want to see their victory dance.
Okay.
Now, just got word that Paul Pierce said, it's time for the Nets to start running New York.
Okay, I agree.
He told reporters at a sprint horse event in Manhattan, and I quote, "The only thing that separates the Knicks and the Nets is a bridge, and both of them are in the same division, and both of them are considered contenders. You can't help but say that this is probably going to be the best rivalry in sports next year."
I think I agree with that. Really quick, vital news. LeBron, jury duty. You don't have any thoughts?
No. I hope he goes to jail.
Okay, now that's just flat out crosses the line. Before we end this, I want to break... Okay. Actually, I want to talk about one thing. Because today, we had this huge argument over LeBron, Magic, Kobe in their prime.
Magic is not really in the conversation.
Okay, so LeBron, Kobe in their prime. We both disagree on this. He's fired up about Kobe, and I'm fired up about LeBron. You know what? I want you to go first.
First of all you viewers, if you have any opinion, please put in the comments. We'd like to hear what you
And
like
you know
to
what?
Say.
Call 949-456-2911 if you want to.
Say that again. I don't think I heard.
949-456-2911. So, go ahead about Kobe.
Well, I just flat out think Kobe was a better player in his prime. LeBron, okay, people still say LeBron is in his prime. I think this coming season will be his last season.
Oh my goodness!
Okay. No. Hey, we have the hill. We have the hill. Everyone talks about the peak.
Yeah.
LeBron will be reaching his peak. The start of 2014-2015 season, LeBron will slowly start to decline.
LeBron, okay.
He won't be in his peak. Is
Bo Jackson of basketball. He's the most conditioned athlete you can find. He extends his prime by 5 years, in my opinion.
So you're saying LeBron's turning 29 in December. Will LeBron be in his prime at 34 like Kobe is?
Yes.
If you say that, then Kobe's still in his prime.
Well, technically, you could say that. I mean,
Kobe is still.
No, but injuries have set him back, though.
Kobe?
What happened?
Achilles and the game against the Hawks. When he
got Jalen Rose, that was pretty funny.
He said he's going to get revenge. Okay. I don't know what he means by that. I don't know if he's going to bring a 2x4.
He's no Latrell Sprewell. He's no Latrell Sprewell. I'm not choking PJ Carlos Simone next. No, you know what? I want to get a 2x4 and slap Mark and get right into Mark Mattson's face and threaten him never to do that dance ever again.
Atrocious.
Okay, but LeBron. Okay, we're going to break this down. Competitiveness. Who's better?
Kobe.
No!
Kobe.
Oh, my goodness.
I will tell you this.
People carry it differently.
No. Kobe is the most competitive athlete in American sports history.
Okay, but you can't, just because LeBron pumps his chest, you know, gets in guys' face, there's different types of leadership and the way you carry yourself out on the floor.
You just said competitiveness has nothing to do with leadership. It's with the drive in you. What does competitive have to do with competitiveness is within you.
No. Competitiveness can drive leadership and take your guys under your wing to the promised
land. Well, if we're talking about LeBron and Kobe, they're already supposed to be leaders. LeBron's not really a leader, in my opinion.
Oh, my. Okay, tell me one thing. Okay.
I like
who's LeBron. A better passer?
LeBron.
Who's a better defender?
Okay, bring it back.
Who's
bring
a better?
It back.
Okay,
bring
it back. Who's a better help defender?
We don't. Okay, bring it back. LeBron has more court vision. Better passer.
Who understands the tempo of the game better?
Kobe. LeBron is fast.
No. What I mean by tempo of the game, I mean when things are going chaotic, who slows it down and says, let's just get into our offense?
Kobe Bryant does!
Oh my god, I can't believe. Kobe is the one guy who, when things go wrong, he tries to take it upon himself to go 1-on-5.
No, but Kobe Bryant still knows. Kobe Bryant still knows when to speed it up and when to slow down. I guarantee you that. You cannot tell me Kobe Bryant does not know. You cannot tell me he knows how to change speed.
Who's a better teammate? Off the court. You better not say Kobe Bryant or I'll run out of this room.
Kobe and Powell are really close.
No, I'm saying compared to LeBron.
Kobe doesn't like to hang out with teammates.
Exactly.
He's very isolated. He doesn't want their stupidity to rub off on him. Okay, I take that.
Oh, come on. So is Pau Gasol stupid?
No, just because Michael's like that. Michael's isolated himself a lot.
No, he didn't. He went out. Phil Jackson said he'd go out of movies with Scottie Pippen, with Dennis, with Steve Kerr, with Paxson, with everybody.
Kobe is so professional. He gets home. All right, after a game, takes a shower, gets home, sometimes with his family. Cause he's in the game at 7:30.
Should I even mention Colorado?
What?
Colorado.
The rape?
Yeah, you think he's really a family man? You want to bring that into the conversation?
I follow him on Instagram. He's with his family all the time.
Oh come on! I could say that about anybody.
No.
He puts on an image just to get people to buy into what. No.
Colorado was a long time ago. Colorado is equivalent to the decision.
So a rape is compared to someone doing a 30-minute special just saying, I'm going to the Miami Heat. No! A rape is a crime, and a decision is a decision.
Will they both be had in their careers? Yes. Will people forget about the decision? No. Will people forget about the rape? Eventually, yes.
No, they won't. No, they won't. They won't ever forget about that. More people will forget about the decision than the rape.
No, no. More people will forget about the. Okay, maybe not forget about it, but they're both. The reason I say they're equivalent to each other is they're both highlighted in their careers.
Okay, you can't tell me though that. Okay, you agree LeBron's best right now.
Oh, obviously.
He's
6 years younger, of course.
Okay.
If Kobe was 28, Kobe better than right now.
No.
If Kobe Bryant was 28
years old. It's unbelievable. You know what Shaq said about Kobe in 04?
Shaq never
No,
liked
no, no.
Kobe.
Listen.
Oh, no.
Listen.
He was so mad at him.
Listen to me. All he said. Okay, this is what he said. He said Kobe will be one of the greatest all time if he learns how to get his teammates involved. And he said that LeBron is a step ahead of Kobe Bryant.
When was this?
Of Kobe. He actually said this 08, my opinion. Okay.
Oh, wait, okay. In 08, LeBron is not better than Kobe. In 08, LeBron was
He didn't have a good supporting cast. You can't say that.
08, LeBron just coming off getting sweeped by the Spurs in the finals. LeBron was not better than Kobe in 08. In 08 was 5 years ago. Kobe was 29. LeBron was, we'll say, 23.
Okay, admit it, though. Kobe shoot himself at. Does Kobe shoot the Lakers out of games that they're supposed to win? At times.
No.
Yeah, he does.
Without Kobe Bryant, they wouldn't win the games. They wouldn't. Kobe,
I agree. I'll say this. He's one of the most urgent players, and I really respect that a lot. And
he does not give up. LeBron is cold. LeBron's done. I'm done. I'm going to look for my teammates. I'm just going to. But then again.
He doesn't defer. He makes a smart basketball play.
What Jeff Van Gundy said, and I listened to it so closely, one of the games in this past year's semifinals, Memphis against Oklahoma City, he said one of the most things that hit me so close. For a player, if a player's cold, the way to get back in it on offense is through defense. And Kobe often did that. Kobe
Yeah, LeBron does that too. You gotta,
no!
Oh, what are you talking about? You know what LeBron does? He denies the ball better than Kobe. Admit it. Just admit it. He's a 6'8", 270-pound beast who puts his hand in the passing lane, and if you dare to even throw it in that direction, it's picked off, and he's going to go slam it from the free throw line. You know that.
He's no James White, first of all. He's not slamming anything to the line.
Oh, my God. That's it. In the paint with camera.
No.
Oh,
okay. No. No.
What?
Okay, first of all, listed weight, Kobe's 205. How much is LeBron?
270.
That's a 65-pound difference. You know how much 65 pounds
but
is?
But he's a bodybuilder and a Olympic runner at the same time with basketball skills.
Nate Robinson.
When have you ever seen that?
Nate Robinson can go toe-to-toe athletic.
He's a Bo Jackson who can play the game of basketball.
Is LeBron James the most athletic player in the league?
Yes.
No. I honestly think Nate Robinson.
Strength, jumping,
Nate Robinson. He's not better than skill-wise. He can go toe-to-toe LeBron James every day. Athletically, yes. Jumping. LeBron does not have that much hops. He just throws down the ball so hard it looks like he does.
So Dominique Wilkins doesn't have that many great hops either.
Oh, he does. LeBron doesn't, though.
LeBron, I mean, that's has, to me, I think Dominique Wilkins and LeBron are similar dunkers.
No.
Yeah, they
Dominique
are.
Got above the rim. LeBron just throws.
LeBron doesn't sneak barely above the rim.
He doesn't, but he doesn't get super high.
Now, okay, who does better fast break blocks, Kobe or LeBron? Just admit it. You won't admit it because you have Lakers bias. You're like another John Ireland or Beto Durant.
No.
You're
no.
another Beto.
Ah! LeBron had major hops in it when he was younger.
You know what? You should just go work for Beto. Beto Durant is one of the more...
Actually, everything I said about his hops, I take that back. LeBron does have hops, but I still think he can physically... Nate Robinson can physically, on a physical standpoint, nothing skill, so all skill aside for both players, they are... LeBron and Nate Robinson are the most athletic. What can Nate Robinson not do?
He's not stronger than him.
Oh, look at the size. And Nate Robinson is very strong for his size. And have you seen his muscles?
No, he is. Don't get me wrong, but...
He could be stronger than him.
I don't think he's faster than LeBron.
Yes, he is.
No.
He's one of the quickest players in the NBA.
No, he's not faster than LeBron. I'm talking about a sprint.
Yeah, on a sprint. LeBron's...
You know what? Let's go do... We should go do a suicide with them.
LeBron's just fast with the ball without the ball. He's slow.
So can he beat everybody in suicides in practice?
He can't beat Norris Cole?
He can't beat Norris Cole in a suicide.
No.
Eric Spoelstra would cry if he heard that.
I don't care. Eric Spoelstra's not even the great coach.
But just forget it. We're going to go. Or
no.
You share something.
One last thing.
Can we talk about Beto Durant for like 2 minutes?
Can I say something about...
Okay.
The reason why I don't think Eric Spoelstra's won a coach of the year is because people think... He has LeBron. He has Wade.
No, he's
such
a
great
smart
leaders.
Coach.
He's worked his
he's,
way up.
He's not better than George Karl or a Brian Shaw, but or he's not better than a
Pop,
or he's not better than a Doc Rivers or a Tom Thibodeau. But he's a top 10 coach.
Yeah, by far, because coaching decisions were a lot in the NBA Finals and in the semifinals. The way he was able to give his guys minutes after going through two straight games, after going through a game 7, getting thrown into another one with a very rested Spurs team, I give him credit, but the coach who can lead his team to a playoff who was not supposed to, maybe a Rick Adelman.
I think Rick Adelman is one of the best coaches ever in NBA history.
Top 10, I give him top 10.
And I think Red Auerbach is the best ever.
Phil Jackson.
Red Auerbach. He actually brought fundamentals to the game, not this ABA stuff where, you know, in the ABA and AAU are the same, basically. All they do is fast break, no defense. You know why Dr. J never beat the Portland Trailblazers in the finals?
Why?
Because he just tried to out-athleticize people and then try to go, like, And then the 76ers would just try to go
solo. That's exactly what LeBron does. LeBron tries to out-athleticize people.
Well, Kobe tries to go 1-on-5. So, boom, there you go. He's Stephen A. Smith, and I'm Skip A. Oh, no, I'm just kidding. He's Jordan Hunter, and I'm
what
Cameron
Beto?
Today.
Beto, what do you say about
okay, Beto? Real quick about Beto. Okay, let me not be disrespectful to Beto because he's coming on the show later, a different show.
Beto!
But he's on Time Warner Cable Sportsnet, and we talked to him a few days ago. He came to a camp.
Does he know John Ireland, you think?
Yeah, he does. They work with each other on Time Warner Cable.
I hate John Ireland, by the way. John Ireland said that Chris Paul is...
Okay, that's just flat-out blasphemous. At least we agree on something.
Chris Paul is the most underrated point guard in
the league. Thank God we agree on something.
Point guard in the league, which I don't think because Chris Paul's always talked about.
I know. Chris Paul... Actually, I think Chris Paul... Okay, this is going to be a little crazy. Don't go crazy. I think Chris Paul at times is a little overrated.
I don't think he's overrated.
I feel like sometimes he gets a pass.
Because
I feel like he puts so much blame and rage on the floor to DeAndre and Blake and everybody else. So the media portrays that as, oh, they're not hard workers.
No, I think Chris Paul is the best leader in the league by far.
I think Chauncey Billups is. Just agree with me on this one.
He's a mentor. He's not a leader.
Same.
No. Oh, mentor is someone to look over. Chris Paul is the best leader. He may not be the best point guard, but guys like Derrick Rose is so quiet. He's such a quiet guy. If he spoke more.
Yeah, but he leads by example.
I don't think he's a leader though. I don't think he's a leader because he leads by. I think
Ben Roethlisberger leads by example.
But I don't think he's not one of the great leaders.
That's true.
You got to be able to. Hey, you over there.
LeBron does that.
Yeah, but I don't.
Just say he's a leader.
He's a leader.
Okay, good. Bye. We're done. In the paint with Cameron and Jordan, really appreciate it.
Beto, please.
Okay, Beto. Okay, I'm really frustrated at Beto because I feel like he's a. Same with John Ireland. I know they're in the LA media. They've worked really hard, but they're kind of cocky.
They are.
Okay, Beto, I know you're coming on. You gave some great tips. Same with John Ireland. But Beto and John Ireland sometimes agitate me, and I just want to go punch my TV screen sometimes.
Well, wait, they are a little cocky. Yes, they are.
Okay, we just had to share that. Cameron Sadeghi, a.k.a. Skip.
Jordan Hunter, a.k.a. Stephen A. Smith.
Actually, we hate those guys, but we kind of sounded like
that. I think Stephen A. Smith is a great journalist. He does his work. He prepares.
He used to be, not anymore. Now he's just a mouthpiece.
He is. And he's a little cocky, too. He's really cocky.
Yeah. He just tries to go for the home run on Skip Bayless.
You can't go for the home run.
You know what? We'll talk that next time. You know what? That's it. We're going to play this.
Everybody, work on your Mark Madsen dance.
Yeah. We got to find a way to put on some, we gotta find a way to put a video of Mark Madsen dancing and show what we did too, here.
Maybe get on the show.
Yeah, we need to get Mark Madsen on the show. We'll find a way to do that. We're gonna play this music out and we're gonna go. Please listen to the other shows today coming up. And Beto is coming, so we can't be disrespectful to Beto today. You gotta be on your best behavior when Beto's around. I can't in the middle of the interview, I can't say, hey, Beto, you're crazy, you're this, you're cocky, or else I'm booted off the channel. Same with you. We may get booted off the channel for being disrespectful to Beto Duran. That's okay. Light him up, Fallout Boy, to end this, and we'll see you later.